This conference will now be recorded.
Hey guys, this is Naveen here. Welcome back to Naveen Automation Labs. I hope you guys are learning. So guys, we know that IPL season is going on and I love cricket and I was a cricketer actually and still I play sometime in Bangalore. So I have created one very good utility for you guys and just wanted to show you. This is the example of web scraping. I don't know you guys are heard about it. Web scraping means scrap the data or crawl the data from any particular site, right? So Selenium is one of the best tools available in the market for data scrapping. So I'm not going to explain each and everything. I have already written a very good utility. So what I'm going to do, let's say I'll show you one thing. So I'll do one thing. I'll go to Chrome. You can see that, and you can go to espncricinfo.com and you can go to any live score or any match score. So let's see, yesterday we had this match, right? That Super Kings, Chennai Super Kings, they won by 80 runs. And this is a scorecard that for all the batsmen, that how many runs they have created, what is their scorecard, like this, like how many minutes they were there, number of four, six, and strike rate. So what I've done that I want to print the entire dashboard, entire scorecard, along with the second inning also. So Delhi Capitals as well as, let's see, Chennai Super Kings. So I'm gonna write. I have already written actually, I have already written a very generic utility. We just need to pass the URL and the entire scoreboard will be sent it to you, will be given to you. So what I have done, that simple Selenium web driver I have used, and I quickly explained that, okay, this is what the URL I'm launching. Directly I'm coming on that particular URL. I'm talking about this URL. So whatever the URL is there, and I have created some script and one method is there that, okay, get player scorecard. So I'm just calling this method over here and on the basis of total number of batsmen available on the page, right? So total number of batsmen available on the page, and I'm just keep looping it and formatting it and getting the scorecard of each and every player, right? So I can upload this particular I can upload this utility on my GitHub. I'll provide the link URL over there. You can have a look and you can in fact create the jar file. So at the end of this video, we will create the jar file also, and we will execute this jar file from the command line, from the terminal, so that on the terminal itself we are getting the scorecard. So you don't need to open the browser. Whenever you want to check the scorecard, you just need to hit one command. You just execute this jar file and then you will get it. So this is something like a daily basic routine automation activity. I generally do that, you know. So in fact, you guys also can do it, right? So this is a very simple code, guys. This is simple web scrapping. I'm just getting a batsman list, looping it out, and for every batsman, I'm just checking the scorecard and I'm printing it on the console on the basis of some dynamic expert. Very simple, very straightforward, like this. So first I'll show you that how exactly it is working. I'm launching this, I'm running this URL. I mean, running this program, and let's see what exactly is happening. So you see that Chrome browser got launched, and you can see then the console output after some time. You can see that duplicis and complete scorecard is coming over here, right? Isn't it amazing that for both the sites? So if you match the scorecard also, so see, the first batsman was name was duplicis, right? He scored around 39 runs, 41, 60 minutes, 2 fours and 6 sixes. Same thing, 39, 41, 60 minutes, 2 fours, 2 sixes, 95.12 strike rate, something like this, right? Same thing for second guy. Watson got out yesterday, okay, at 0 run. So 0 is there, then 59, then 44. So the last batsman was Raidu. So for Raidu, see, this is the scorecard. Raidu made around 5 runs in 2 balls. And then Prithvi Shaw came for the second inning from Delhi. So Prithvi Shaw made around how many runs? 4 runs. So this is the second innings. So for all the batsmen, you will keep getting the output. So let's see, I don't know. Let's see the current, I'll go to ESPN. I'll do one thing. Let's go to Cricket Info and live cricket updates. And currently live is going on this. Okay. So I'll click on it and I'll take this, still match is going on. So I'll go to the scorecard, and the scorecard is this, that Mumbai is already played. Okay, and Mumbai, they scored around 162 for 5, and Hyderabad is still playing. So I'll do one thing, I'll just copy this URL and then I'll take this URL in my script, right? So this is something amazing, guys. So let me take this URL Okay, so I'll take this URL and what I'll do, I'll just execute it and let's see what is the scorecard I'm getting. And just see the console. Okay, so browser is getting launched. And let's see if the scorecard is coming or not. Okay, it's something we are getting 9. Okay, so maybe, yeah, something we are getting. Prithvi Shah is still playing and Guptil is still playing. So we are getting something over here. Maybe this is the hidden, right? So maybe I have to add one more slip like this, but it's giving the current scorecard. You can see that for Prithvi Shah, it's saying 7, right? So this is current actually 6, 7 and 7, 7. So this is the exact thing we are getting over here. So what I'll do, let's see the previous scorecard, maybe some other matches. So we'll do one thing. Okay, I'll do one thing. Let me go back to this and maybe some other match which has already happened. So okay, so let's see for another match. Let's see. Okay, we will take this some other matches, maybe for yesterday match. For yesterday match again, okay, let's see for a different match. Royal Challenge Bangalore and Rajasthan Royals. So I'll take this and go to scorecard. And you can see the scorecard is this for both the team. And just copy this and we will see. We'll test with this scorecard. Whatever happened, whatever the scorecard were there, the exact scorecard is coming or not. Okay, so let's run it and let's see. So yes, browser is getting launched. And yeah, this is the scorecard. And let's see, are we getting the correct output or not? So yes, 11. So Virat Kohli made around 25 runs. Yeah, not around, so yeah, 25 runs, 7 balls. So this is the scorecard, right? And it was because of rain, it got stopped and then it was only for a few overs. So you can see the exact scorecard. Virat Kohli, 3 sixes, 1 4. We are getting the same thing, 3 sixes, 1 4, 11 minutes, 7 ball, 25 runs. So we are getting an ABD2 Saini and then Samson and Livingstone. So Samson and Livingstone were playing from there. So, right. So guys, this is like a very good utility I have created. It's a very simple code. You can check it later. Now what I'm going to do that I'm going to create one jar file. So every time I don't want to open the clips, what I'll do, I'll just create the jar file and then upload it somewhere in my desktop or maybe on C drive or D drive or somewhere. And I'll keep executing it and keep checking the result. Okay. So I'll do one thing, that right click on it and just simple click on export. We will create one runnable jar file, right? So simple click on this runnable jar file, click on next. And from here, you will select your class name. So this is my package name and this is my class name. And let's see, my jar file name is cricket_jar. Right, and click on finish. Okay, and yes. Okay, so now what I'll do, I'll go to my terminal. So this is my terminal. Terminal means your command prompt, and I already tested over here. I'll do one thing. We have to maximize it. Okay, so I've already saved this particular jar file on my desktop, right? It's on my desktop. I'll show you. I will go to my desktop and on my desktop, cricket score.jar file is there, right? So I'll do one thing, I'll execute this jar file from the command line. So I'll simple write java-jar, how to execute your jar file. So this is a command, java-jar and then cricket score.jar file, right? And then simple run it. So yes, it is working and then it is launching the browser and you can see on the console output over here in the terminal, we should get the result. You can see that the complete result we are getting. So this is called, guys, web scrapping. We are scrapping the data from the website. So we are scrapping the cricket score like this, right? So what I'll do, that I can give this particular utility to anyone. So what I want, I don't want to launch the URL, I want to run it in headless mode. So we can do that in headless mode also. Remember, in Chrome options class we have this argument, headless argument, and I'll just pass CO. Okay, this Chrome options reference I have created, class object I have created, I'm passing this headless browser name, I mean headless parameter as an argument, and I'm passing the CO. That's it. And I'll do one thing, that I want to make it generic, right? It's not like that every time only for this particular URL you give me the scorecard. No, I just pass the URL at the runtime from the command prompt. So what I'll do, whenever you are passing any parameter from the command prompt, it will give into main method args. So I'm gonna comment this particular line, okay guys, and then I'll do one thing, driver.get whatever that you value you are getting, okay, from the command prompt from the terminal, which will be stored inside this particular array. I'm just using args zeroth value. It means give me the zeroth value, and zeroth value we are passing as an URL from the command line. So I'll show you how to do that, right? So I'll create this jar file once again because we have made the changes. So whenever you are making the changes, guys, we have to create the jar file again and again. Okay, so I'll do one thing, click on export, runnable jar file, and yeah, click on finish. Okay, you want to replace? Yes, I want to override this. Fine, and then click on okay. So again, a new jar file got created, and I'll execute it. So now this time you will see the browser will not be launched. Okay, but here you have to pass the URL. So what is my URL? So let's see, I'll pass the same URL, this particular URL. Just a second, or I'll take it from here. Right, this is a URL. Okay, and then here you have to pass it like this in double quotes. So java-cricket-score.jar, and this is my parameter, which this parameter will be given to the main method args0, because I've already explained so many times that main method will be called by JVM, will be called by Java. So this is a Java is calling this cricket-score.jar file. Program will get into the main method, and okay, we are passing this args value like this. So this is called command line argument parameter passing, and then I'll just simple enter. And here, without opening the browser, see, browser is not getting opened, and the scorecard should be displayed over here after a few seconds. See, perfect. You can give this particular utility to anyone. They don't need to open the browser again and again. They just need to hit this particular URL, and then they will get the scorecard. So let's see what is the current score, what is the current match is going on. So let's go back to this, and today is okay. I'll check what is the match is going on. Let's see for one more match is going on, right? This team, this is a county team, or maybe North Group Royal London One Day Cup is at Manchester is happening. So I'll go to the scorecard, and let's see what is the current score is going on. So I'll take this URL, I'll go to terminal, and then I'll do one thing. Let me clear it. I'll simply write java-jar cricket scorecard.jar, and then enter the URL, and then enter. So let's see, are we getting something or not? Okay, so yes, we are getting the scorecard over here, but maybe in a different format. So maybe there are some changes over there, but we are getting some scrapping over here, right? So you can see that the scorecard is displayed over there, that LM Rees and some this guy BA Goldman, LM Rees and BA Goldman, 19 runs, 29 balls. So you can see that 19 runs, 29 balls, and 42-59. So we are getting the scorecard over here as well. Okay. So like that, guys, you can print it, and it's giving you the bowler, okay, thing also, 9 overs, 29 runs, something like this, like that also maybe we are getting. Okay, so guys, this is really cool. I'm not saying this is the perfect one. Maybe we here and there I can make it more generic, more appropriately I can write it, but for the previous scorecard also you can take it. And such kind of example people might ask you at a time of interview, especially for web table handling. Right, so let's see, we will go to this more previously, let's see, 27 29, Sunrise Hyderabad and Punjab, and this was the scorecard like this. And let me check quickly once again for this is working or not. So for three, four examples I have already tested, but let's see if this is working or not. Okay, so I'll simply write, okay, let me write it again, java-jar cricket score.jar this and enter. So let's see what we are getting. So total number of batsmen were 18 and we are getting the complete scorecard for us, right? So guys, this is a script that I have written. Maybe you can modify it. You can write some more scripts, add some more methods you can add, okay, in your code, that you just pass the player name and get the scorecard of only that particular player name. That I've already written actually, but I'm printing all the inside the loop for every player. Okay, for every player I'm getting the scorecard. But you can create one more method which will return the scorecard of only the specific scorecard. So you just need to pass that, okay, java-jar, pass Virat Kohli. You will get the scorecard of Virat Kohli, like this. So this is just a scrapping. We are scrapping means scrap the data, get the data, the runtime data, or maybe history data, okay, from any particular website or any particular web application. So guys, you can do it. And you can take this example by your own. So I'll do one thing. I'll just upload this complete code in my Git repository. You can just have a look over there. And whenever you want, you can create the jar file and take it. I'll see that, okay, I can, if I can upload the jar file over there as well. You can download the jar file, execute the same command with this particular URL, whatever the URL you want to use, okay, that I've explained over there. So it's up to you. You guys can use it and then enjoy the IPL. So thank you so much, guys. This is just a very basic thing I really wanted to cover, that how to do web scrapping. Okay, a couple of people actually asked me over there. So that's why I thought of creating one video on this. So keep watching Naveen Automation Labs, guys. Thank you so much. I'll see you later. Thank you so much.